Zoom has changed a lot since the pandemic days, and it's not just a meeting experience for booking online meetings, but it's also a combination of productivity softwares that teams can use to bring everything into one place. Today, we're going to take a look at Zoom Calendar and Zoom Mail. These are clients that you can use for free and get access to some of the basic abilities that you'd see in Microsoft 365 and also in Gmail or Google Workspace. We're going to show you around them and how they work in this video. So welcome, if you're new here, you can get a buyer's guide to finding the best calendar application on the market. We also have buyer's guides for note-taking apps and to-do list apps as well, if you're interested. You'll find them linked below. And also, if you're interested in jumping over to toolfinder.co to explore the best resources and tools on the market, then you can find that link there too. So naturally, Zoom Workspace is evolved quite a lot, and maybe even since last time you checked it out. And as you can see here, this is what it looks like. Now, as you can see at the top, there's a bunch of different services that are now available. Team chat, all the way over to documents. There's even a note-taking app inside of this experience that uses Markdown impressively. But let's show you through some of the abilities, starting with calendar. So they claim that this is a secure experience, and of course, what it does, very simply, it connects with Microsoft 365 and Google Workspace, meaning you can essentially connect it up in this top left-hand corner and add an account. Now, before we begin, it's very simple. They have quite a clear policy on how this is set up. You get a Zoom calendar experience if you're using the Zoom Pro, and then you get one third-party experience. So you can see here that I've connected up a Google Workspace account, but you can connect up a Microsoft account. Now, in order to, you know, connect up one, you do need to go through the processes, so do make sure you're happy with the policy that they have in place. So once you've got one connected, it'll start importing the items into your calendar. And it works very much like many other calendar applications with a few differences. So as you can see on this left-hand side, I can see any of the calendars associated to my calendar, which is quite helpful. And also up here, you can skip to work week view as well. Now, I found this to be quite fast and easy to use, and I had no problems setting things up. There were a few limitations that I'll talk about in a moment in terms of what it can do in terms of connecting with other conferencing tools. So as you can see here, you can go into settings and modify some of the details before you begin, things that you would expect, like a secondary time zone, which is something that's available in some premium applications. And of course, you get the calendar experience for free, which is pretty good. Now, creating an event is really simple. However, there's quite a lot of detail involved, more so than other applications. And of course, you've got that 40-minute limit on meetings, which is now part of the basic plan of Zoom Workspace. But you can see here that I can even add an event, some focus time, and also an out-of-office item as well, whether that's shown publicly or privately. But everything can be added here. And the main limitation is that you cannot add additional video conferencing tools. For example, you can add an offline meeting where you can add a location and room, but when it comes to a Zoom meeting, that's the only option that you can add. Obviously, that sort of makes sense because there's some limitations. They want you to use Zoom, but that's the sort of basics. Now, down here, you can add things like description, attachments, and other such details, as well as using an external calendar. You can also invite people and set it up as an enable it as a continuous meeting chat too. So adding an event is quite good. Now, here's one I actually created from Google Calendar. It was already available on my account. And as I mentioned just then, some of the limitations here are that I did put in a Google Meet details here. So if I go to edit, I'm not able to find that. Even in the description, they haven't even posted it there. So I'm sort of stuck on how I'm gonna get access to that meeting if I'm using a third-party service. However, if you're using Zoom, you'll find that it works pretty well. Up here, you can invite people and do the regular stuff. And you may have already noticed on this right-hand sidebar, there's actually a way to see your upcoming meetings. And this is perfect if you use Zoom as a way to collect up, for example, it could be consultancy or maybe even booking some advice, whether that be office hours or whatever. Using a software like this will allow you to see the upcoming meetings. But what's nice as well is you can join them straight away, especially if they're Zoom orientated meetings, which is helpful. Now up here, you can add new events, but there's also a way to change the background color if you want to, which is something that just gives you an idea of just a bit of personality if you want to. You can skip ahead to a certain date as well. For example, Friday, I've got a call here and I can see it with a bit of details open here. Now, in terms of the mail experience, again, this one's free and works in the same structure as you've seen with calendar. You're only allowed to add an additional third-party client. And if you did want to add additional abilities, obviously you're gonna need to access Zoom Mail. Now, the differences are that these are clients and this is its own service, which means that with Zoom Mail, you're obviously linked in with Zoom Pro, which gives you a Zoom One domain name. So basically, think about setting up a new mail account from scratch. But this is handy for getting started for sure. Now, it looks very similar to Gmail, and it sort of works in the exact same way. You can see that you can set it up as a list or a vertical view, as well as horizontal view too. Now, there are a few additional options in terms of unread emails and how they appear, as well as modifying text size. But you can also see things like the composer, whether you're on vacation, and some filters that you can set up for specific things as too. So this is really the basic email experience that you can use. There's obviously search, and creating emails is pretty basic as well. To be honest, this one's probably for those who are using Gmail or Google Workspace or Microsoft 365 and just want to be able to bring their experience into the house with Zoom. If you and your team are using Zoom a lot, or you are an individual that books a lot of meetings through Zoom, whether that's through consultancy services or through organizing webinars or things like that, then having everything in one location reduces something called context switching, which a lot of business professionals are looking at these days, so they don't jump between applications and distract their time. Now, there is a third experience which sort of correlates to the calendar abilities, and it's called Scheduler. I'm expected to do this in another video. If you're interested in that, please do subscribe. But largely, it's basically a Calendly alternative, allowing you to book a meeting externally using a single link or with group, and you can customize this in quite a high level of detail. Now, in terms of the offering that this brings together, whilst it does limit you to one calendar and one mail account per third-party experience, it does give you the basics. And if you're using Zoom and you want to get started with it, then it's not going to be a bad experience for you. It's just something that might be slightly more accessible when you're using Zoom every single day. So that was how they both work. You can access Zoom through the link below and of course explore it in more detail. If you're still hunting for calendar apps or email apps that we've mentioned, or you're interested in more, then you can jump over to toolfinder.co, jump over to the email and calendar section and quickly find the best resource for you. So I hope that it helps you find the best tool, and hopefully it gave you a good overview of Zoom Calendar and how it works. Thank you very much, folks, and I'll talk in a future video, I'm sure. Cheerio for now.